guys, welcome to another episode of the Galerie Darshana. Today I'm going to explain to you the 18 hand punches or the 18 hand attacks. This I will do on request of one of my followers. So I will go through all the 18 little forms. First, a little explanation about the term 18 hand attacks or 18 hand forms and hand punches. Okay, first the number 18. Well, there are actually no 18 hand punches because the number 18 actually is a symbolic number. So it refers to something complete, something perfect, something which is handed down from master to student in a complete sense. So that about 18. Second, the hand punches or hand attacks. Well, they are hand attacks, but actually it's a little bit oversimplified to say it's only about hands. Because, for example, the first one goes is a kind of knife, the attack to the throat, and it goes like this. Well, that's it. But the 18 hand punches, it's a very dynamic way of learning how to deal with hand attacks or hand punches. Each of the 18 hand attacks or hand punches are done in three positions of the body. First, the upright position, so you're going to attack in this way. Second, what we call the lion position, so you go attack in this way. And the third, we go in the horse position, we go and attack in this way. Each of these three positions is influencing the way the impact is reached on the body of the opponent. So let's go a little bit back. Let's go to the first hand punch. So I told you the first one is a kind of cutting hand, like this. Actually, we are attacking the opponent with this bone. So like this. Second would be in the lion position. So the attack will be in this way. The third will be in the horse position. So the attack will be in this way. Each of these three positions, they have its own dynamics and its own influence on the punch. So, for example, when I, as I just done now, I give here a punch in this way, and I use now a horse. You can see that the angle in which I can give the punch is now the same as the angle my leg has with the floor. So the lion punch goes like this. So it is no longer in an horizontal plane. It goes in a kind of diagonal plane. So the punch changes from a straight punch to a tilted punch. As for the inner dynamics concerns, well, you can turn your body with the punches. Actually, a normal punch, your whole body is going behind the punch. That means you're starting from the ball of your foot to the knee, from the hip to the shoulder, to the elbow, and then to the hand. So that will define if you align all these points behind your punch. If you align it, you get the maximum power out of it. I will demonstrate these inner dynamics to you with the following example. I want to cut somebody in the throat in this way. My hand goes in a horizontal plane, the cutting hand. Okay, now I want to align my body behind the punch in order to generate more power. Well, I start with the ball of the foot, I use my knee and my hip. So I pivot on the ball of the foot and I rotate my leg inside. At the meantime, I'm stretching the knee and I bring the ball and the foot of the foot and the knee under my hip. The whole rotation comes now from the hip. So I rotate the hip in this way. After rotating the hip, I align my shoulder with the hip in this way. After that, my elbow and my hand will follow. So you get the cut in this way. This is the normal cut. And this is when it's aligned. So I snap, as it were, my leg out in order to generate power. So again, it goes like this. You see, when the end position is a stretched leg, and immediately I'm going to relax and I go back in the starting position. There is though a small secret to this cut. I also work with my shoulder. So it's not only that I put my hips and the ball of my foot and my leg behind this punch. No, I'm also taking actually my shoulder. If this is the straight line, is this the central line of your opponent? I'm pulling my shoulder a little bit out of the center line in towards this direction. And I give, as it were, a punch in this way. If you do that, you will generate again extra power inside the punch you're going to deliver on your opponent. So, how can I demonstrate that? Maybe if I stand a little bit like this. It goes like this. This. So, I'm bringing the shoulder a little bit this side. Then I'm going to, with a snap, I'm going to align my leg behind my punch. So again, this will be the final punch. Since this is a cutting movement, you can also use it with a knife. So we have this cut. And of course, you can take the knife like this, and we give him a thrust in the throat. So the blade will go like this in the throat, in the neck actually, like this. But that movement requires similar dynamics, like this. But suppose I'm standing here and I want to cut his throat here in front. So nicely, I want to cut the veins in the throat of the opponent. How do I generate then the most power? First, demonstrate you without the knife. I'm standing here, and then I want to cut actually on this line, and I want to actually to put not the force, I don't want to put the force inside the body, but I want to put the force along the body, actually in front of the body. So we have a nice cutting movement. Because a cutting movement, it always cuts. So you must keep the cutting movement. So, how do we do that? I'm standing like this. And again, I'm going to snap my foot in this direction in order to generate power from the hip and the ball of the foot. But now, I'm not going to work with the shoulder like this, because the shoulder like this will have a deep impact in the opponent's body. But what you want to do is a cut. So, I give a cut in this way. So it is this way. So I bring, as it were, my hand and I draw it back. Really as a cut, like this. So, it will be, eventually, look like this. Meantime, you see, my body is rotating completely over the central line, like this. And my end position is not that I straighten my leg, but it is a little bit bent leg in front of the opponent, like this. As it were, you are standing inside the hind leg in order to draw your hand back. This position. So, in this way. interesting thing is that when you have a knife like this and you want to, and you go in this position in order to have the maximum cutting movement, so not a pushing movement like this, but a cutting movement in this way, you use your little finger in order to generate the final power. So as soon as you are here, so if you're here, here's your opponent. If you're reaching your opponent, you're going to squeeze your little finger inside the knife, the hilt of the knife, like this. You see, it already gets an extra movement in. It creates an extra movement. Extra rotation means extra force behind your cut. So it will be like this. This. And all power generation starts from the ball of the foot. In this case, it goes directly to the spine. And from there, it travels to the shoulder, to the hand. Actually, it travels to the little finger. And then you make your final cut. Let's now examine how this cutting movement works in the three positions. First, we've done already. This is the cut in the horizontal plane. Now we go a little bit lower in the lion. And also this, you can see, it's in the horizontal plane. And also here, you work with your shoulder, you put your shoulder a little bit out of the middle line, a little bit outside the middle line, in order to generate extra power. But now, the other one, the horse stance. You're standing in the horse, you're going to generate like this. And you see already, the arm goes up automatically. As I told you, this position creates an angle in your movement. So, you're getting this cutting movement like this. So what do the 18 hand attacks teach you? Actually, you should practice with these 18 hand techniques. Each punch, which I'm going to show you, you are going to do in these three positions. That's what I do here, and here, and here. And you should feel, as it were, experiment with your own hands, what the impact of this hand punch is on your opponent. You can use a boxing bag, or you can you can do it with a partner. But every punch, in combination with your pose, is one of these three poses, will have an impact on the punch, the area where you can punch, and the impact, the angle on the which your punch is going to touch the body, as it were. So this will be a 30 degree angle, more or less, if I stand like this. So you have a 30 degree angle in this way. So how you should ask yourself when you practice this cut, for example, or any other punch, what is the effect on the opponent's body when I use this punch? You should feel it, you should experiment with it, you should really put time on this, because this are really the inner dynamics of actually any martial art, because any martial art will make use of such hand techniques. So this is a tool for you to experiment, to see what is going to happen when you launch a punch. So the first punch was the cut. Second punch is the sword cut. The sword cut is then done like this. And it goes in kalaipayat. It goes with a step and a circular movement of the hand and a cut from up to down in a circular fashion, like this. So you can already imagine that this kind of punch is not really for within a boxing ring, but is used mainly for weapons, for example, sword cuts or spear attacks with a spear or with a long stick. So The first position is the upright position. I'm going to do the sword cut. So this will be my sword cut. Actually, you cannot really practice it in this way. You should imagine here in the shoulder of the opponent, and this goes with a step, and you're going to attack the collarbone like this. Okay, now we do it in the lion stance. We stand like this. We're going one step forward and exercise again the same punch. Like this. You see, my arm is already a little bit bended in order to generate a little bit more power. So it's not stretched anymore. Actually, official sword hand is with a stretched arms. But in this case, you should imagine a sword cutting like this, and it's already, it should be a little bit bended. Otherwise, you're going to hurt your elbow. Okay, then in the third position, now you see in many forms the sword cut done in the horse position, and it goes like this. So we have here circular fashion. Actually, it's a lunge, and after the lunge, you're going to close the distance between you and the opponent. So you use the weapon, your weapon for it, but also you're using the step for it. So you're a little bit at a distance. I'm going to close it, and immediately from the closing, after the closing, I'm going to attack. So here's the lunge and the attack. The third one is an attack which is actually the basic punch of Kalaipayat. It is this punch. You use the open hand and you give an attack like this. So it's a straight attack in a straight line, and you do it like you're throwing a ball like this. This is the movement. So the ball throw. So you actually start from here, you bring your hand to the ear, and then you're going to attack. You're going to deliver the punch. So you see this in almost all forms of the southern style, and you see it a little bit less frequent, but also quite frequent in the northern styles and central styles. So the first one, upright position. This is also the basic position of this hand attack. By the way, if you do it in the upright position and I launch the attack like this, you should hit here the bridge of the nose or the third eye here. These are the ideal spots for this attack. Okay, now I go a little bit lower, stand in the lion, and the lion, as I explained to you already, is especially for iron weapons like sword, or yeah, it's also for short sticks, but it's a weapon stance. So it's very designed for weapons. And let's see how this hand attack is performed when I'm standing in the lion. There it goes. I'm going. And you see, there is something with the foot and the attack. So I must be a little bit aware of the foot and what my hand is doing. So this is better. So apparently now I have felt that the attack is a little bit outside of my body. So if this is my lion, then my line of attack is a little bit out of this central line, on this side. Or if you stand in the other line, of course, it's on this side. The fourth one is slightly different from the previous one. The previous one is a loose one. You keep your hand in a loose way. So it goes like this. It's like a whip. This one, you keep it a little bit more straight. So it is actually a thrust. So you thrust with the palm of your hand, you thrust inside the body of the opponent. So it's like this. And you end up pushing, actually. You're pushing through his body. So it's not this. It is this one. So if you do that in lying position, you get this one. This one. And you see, if I do like this, it goes straight. If I attack like this, it also goes straight. But if I attack with the horse, again, it goes up. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I hope you have learned a lot. Please pay a lot of attention to these punches. These are really the core. Actually, not only of Kalaipad, it's the core of really every martial art. How to do your punches right. How do you align your body with it? How do you generate energy with your body? This 18 hand punches is just a tool which gives you the feeling how to do it, provided you practice these punches and see what is working for you. Now guys, this is again the end of the video. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please press the like button and forward this video. Thank you very much and see you next time.